Hi, my name is Sophie.
My name is Derek.
My name is Lillian.
Julian.
Caroline.
Amanda.
Patrick.
Claire.
Melody.
Steven.
Alex.
Ali.
Taylor.
Trove. And I'm currently enrolled in Dr. Feruda's music in the community class for spring 2020.
What a quarter it has been with all of the unprecedented world events. Yet, despite everything going on, I was able to learn many things from this class.
This class, I think, is one of my favorite classes over my time at Santa Clara, and it really allowed me to connect with a lot of people that I normally wouldn't have.
A lot of things became a lot more important to me. Suddenly, you know, my whole mindset about homelessness really changed.
Music is a true form of art that does so much more than just something to play or listen to. I learned that music can really help a person heal.
As a class and as a group in particular, we're still able to directly hear and be impacted by the issues of women's survival.
Being exposed to the homeless community on a much deeper level.
It is different seeing and assuming what homelessness is like from an outsider view than talking to someone in person who actually experiences it.
I was a bit nervous about having that kind of conversation. In the end, like, she was totally nice, she was totally fine. I definitely kind of envy, in a weird way, like, her ability to still have, like, a positive attitude and, like, being able to laugh, even amidst all the hardships that she faces that I have never had to deal with.
I had never had much of an experience communicating with veterans before this opportunity, let alone getting to know them and about their personal experiences.
I also was reminded that, you know, there's really true strength in vulnerability, and that no matter your background, it's like we all have these struggles, and that even the strongest people that you know have mountains to overcome.
And I think actually, like, speaking with them and, like, going through the process of creating art is really special. It just reaffirmed my beliefs in that I have a lot of sympathy for those that are homeless, especially women, because I think women can be particularly vulnerable to different situations.
It addressed the implicit privilege that I have of not having to go through that. Not having to worry about that in the moment, not only in general, but in a pandemic.
I had to find emotion that I felt that I could relate to, that Miley and Shalu would also relate to.
Renita has been through more in her life than anyone I know, yet she still remains optimistic through her actions and her attitude.
But here we actually got to sit down, talk to her, got to know Lori as a person, and she's a spectacular human being.
And this really transformed my frame of mind, because I had no idea how difficult and frustrating transitioning back to society in normal life was. And it doesn't seem like it should be hard. It seems like they're just going home, but there's so much more.
Having those group discussions with her just about everything that she had gone through and to where she is right now. But it was also so inspiring to have somebody so happy and upbeat over the phone. After telling us the stories of her life.
She's like a ray of sunshine almost, just, you know, beaming out to everyone. She's always laughing, making other people laugh.
And the effect of every conversation with her would just, like, linger for a while after each class.
She wasn't afraid to share her thoughts. She wasn't afraid to speak her mind. And she was also, at the same time, very kind and warm.
She is the most amazing woman I think I've ever talked to. The strongest, the nicest, the happiest, the most energetic, and she's so inspiring.
Female veterans deserve an incredible amount more support and credit for what they have done. They should not only be seen, but feel seen.
There are so many people in society that don't have a voice to be able to speak out, and that I should stand with them.
Every day is a new day, and if you get a chance to do something good for somebody or really do some good change for the rest of the community, then you need to take the advantage and do it, because, I mean, Renita is honestly one of my biggest inspirations, especially leaving out of college.
And overall, I think the experience was emotional, because getting to be vulnerable with someone else and have them sharing something that's so close and personal to them, but knowing the impact that sharing that can have, I think it was just really powerful. It's giving me goosebumps right now. And I think that that's what's really great about this project, is that you don't have to be in those shoes to understand or to empathize or to realize that, like, it is important.
I can't really understand someone's experience, but I can definitely be empathetic about the emotions that they felt during their experience and convey that message in a way that they can relate to.
It kind of inspired me to get more involved, like, especially in, like, voting.
Not only called me to action, but called my groupmates and called people in this class to action.
For me, I just want to be able to educate people, and I want to be able to help more people the way we have helped Renita. And I think it's just so important that we learn these things and we don't jump to conclusions, and we try to remember that people go through a lot of hard things and we can't judge.
It's just like some of those things that you think about after a class like this. It's very touching, and I can't stop speaking to people about it. Like, everyone I meet, I just want to tell them about my class.
I just want to say to Renita, thank you so much, and you're a beautiful person, and we all really appreciate everything that you were able to tell us.
You have motivated me to become more strong and to never give up despite any obstacles.
Miley and Shalu, thank you so much for being so supportive throughout this process and encouraging to our group. We learned so much from you too. And not only that, but we had so much fun. We hope you did too.
Working with you has been so special and has given me the opportunity to learn so much more about the lives of veterans. And it's shown me that there's much more sacrifice in serving the country than I previously have known. And I'm thankful for you and so many others of how you've served our country.
I'm very, very thankful that I met Renita, who exemplifies that no matter the negative things around you, no matter what's happening, you can always be happy and you can make other people happy along with you.
Thank you so much, Izzy, for working with us. This was an incredible opportunity.
You care for everyone else and you would put other people before yourself. Thank you so much for letting us be a part of your life.
Lori, thank you so much for sharing everything you shared with us, for sharing your story, and for giving us your time to talk to us and all your effort. I just want you to know that I absolutely loved every single second we got to spend with you and your story and what you have to share and your wisdom and your poetry. It's all really, really beautiful, and I hope we get to see each other sometime again.
And also, Tammy, I just really wanted to thank you for, like, working with us. I think I couldn't have imagined a better class to sort of end my graduation as well. It felt a lot more meaningful and impactful, and you are just the sweetest, most positive person, and I'm just so grateful that we were able to work with you and help you share your voice. And so yeah, thank you so much.
Words by Lori. My family history is a part of me. My situation can happen to anyone, not necessarily of choices one makes. Once upon a time, in the wild land where I, the daughter of a war, had a bed to lay. Lincoln's blood running in my veins. Blacksmith's blood flowing to my friend's brain. Mysteries within me, even when survival became the way. San Jose, I came to stay. The earth, history by my side.
Sadly absurd, lost star, no more, no girl, lost girl, My name is Nita, and I was born in Alabama, and I welcome, you know, that we are attacked in this world, you know. What about the babies? What about the elderly people? What about us? You know, Corona, you gotta go.
It's like, it's all in the Bible. You walk and do it in the Bible.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't say how it was gonna go down, but it's going down.
It is.
And instead of just trying to think my whole life story, we ain't gonna go all there a long time. But it's like, I'll tell you that I had cancer, I'll tell you I had 2 strokes, and what about people out here, you know, the elderly people, they're the OGs,
mm-hmm.
You feel me?
Yeah.
And messing with people because my tolerance is low, having cancer and stuff. And then, you know, what about these homeless people out here? They do matter, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Life matters, no matter what color you are.
I'll come back from nowhere. She's on the move. If I don't know what to say, I'm gonna leave your stupid games. I'm not your treat, I'm not your sweet. So keep on moving your damn little feet. See me as some sort of nice guy, but I promise I'm not the right guy. No love is fake, your love is brave. No hope to shape, a heart to save. No love is fake, your love is brave. No hope to shape, a heart to save. If I come back from nowhere, and she's on the moon. If I don't know what to say, I'm gonna leave these stupid games. Just give me a taste. You show no haste. Did I fuck this thing up? Was this all a huge waste? No love is fake, your love is brave. No hope to shake, no heart to save. No love is fake, your love is brave. No hope to shake, no heart to save. No love that's fake, your love is brave. No hope to shake, no heart to save. Love is fake, your love is brave. Hope to shape, but hard to save.
Hey, my name's Nita. I was born in Alabama. I don't have no bandage on my back. I walk with cancer, and I've had 2 strokes. Now Corona's trying to mess with me. Hey, stop messing with the babies. Stop messing with OGs. And what about the homeless people? Corona, Corona, gotta get up out of here. Talk about Corona, yeah. You gotta get up out of here. You gotta get up out of here. Talk about Corona. You gotta get up out of here. That's a little something.
Visible knock, she feeling the chills and she want him to stop. Never acknowledged, I was the kind, but she was the one who did time in the past. Thinking her husband's the one with the time. Trying to get loans, but she can't find a dime. Trickling time, look at the signs. No credit here in the bank of the mind. Yeah, look at the fun love from the VA. Non-stop, trying to be a member of the male land. Sweat shop, carried in a pack full of vent. It's a bag drop, past raining down on her shoulders like a tank top. Life ain't easy for a girl in a man's world trying to get the eyes she deserves. Yeah, trick your ass for a husband and the gears start rolling and the anger start coming like a surf. So it's time for my story. For duty and glory, the price to be paid is a sign. Tense, the loud is the A and the many astray, but for women there isn't a defense.
Is it rage or is it truth?
youth, lived a life apart from youth. Inspired by anger of sickness and health, motivated by trauma and knowledge of self. Take a breath of stale air. Can they see have I been wronged? Extracted from another time. Faces turn, but do they care? Is it rage or is it truth? Lived a life apart from youth. Inspired by anger of sickness and health. Motivated by trauma and knowledge of self.
Complaining a lot, feeling so frustrated with what y'all got. Never feel safe, always on guard. This is the life that she got, it's so hard not to compare. Yes, life ain't fair, but y'all complain about traffic everywhere. These aren't her problems, much more than this. She wants to punch something with her fist. Feeling frustrated with the card she was dealt. So much pressure these hands have felt. So lost without the gun on her belt. Co-workers can't comprehend the feelings she has felt. She saw the bombs, she's been attacked. Feeling at work like no one's got her back. Say something happens, who would protect? Not these people that work at their desk. Reach for her gun, nowhere to be found. Oh, that's right, it's just a playground. Looking around, sweating a lot. This desk job's harder than she thought.
Is it rage or is it truth? Lived a life apart from youth. Inspired by anger of sickness and health. Motivated by trauma and knowledge of self. Take a breath of stale air. Can they see have I been wronged? Extracted from another time. Faces turn, but do they care? Is it rage or is it truth? Lived a life apart from youth. Inspired by anger of sickness and health. Motivated by trauma and knowledge of self.
Being a female vet is largely my identity. How funny how that's not what you see when you look at me and know in fact my name does not begin with Mister. What's so shocking that I'm so much more than just a sister. In fact, I'm a woman and that makes me real proud. I was a frontline medic and lived real life Black Hawk Down. But when I got back home and it was time to transition, I struggled to satisfy my craving for adrenaline. To fulfill this need, I decided to start teaching. But boy, was I confused with people's actions versus their preachings. Society has all these standards, what's right from wrong. Yet to notice injustice all around did not take too long. Quickly, I found expectations aren't what they seem. And this can make a vet so angry, need a blow off steam. See something, say something, I'd advise not always know. Speak up for what is wrong, just please don't whistle blow. What's correct differs between here and Guantanamo. Now living in two extremes, highest highs and lowest lows.
Is it rage or is it truth? Lived a life apart from youth. Is it rage or is it truth? Lived a life apart from youth. Is it rage or is it truth? Lived a life apart from youth.
The first time that I heard the song Beautiful by Mercy Me, it just struck a chord. I immediately started bawling. The first phrase immediately does it.
Days will come when you don't have the strength.
Days will come when you don't have
when
the strength.
All you hear
when all you
is
hear
you're not
is
worth
you're not
anything.
Wondering if you'll ever could be loved.
Wondering if you ever could be loved.
And if they truly saw your heart,
and
they'd
if
see
they
too much.
Truly saw your heart, they'd see too much.
That's exactly how I was feeling. That I was so unworthy and damaged that nobody could love me. I was so ashamed of what happened with the assault. And you combine that with the stalkings and the gropings and all these things that had happened throughout my career. I was just damaged goods. I didn't want to tell my husband about the assault. And it took a lot of time in therapy before I could. I knew he loved me. And I knew it was an unconditional love. But I was so ashamed. And the fact that I had triggered the lock, that I left the door open for the assailant to come in, that it was my fault. For so long, I thought that. And this song just helped me see that. That's not true. That I am still beautiful. That I am made for so much more than this. Than this instance. Than this assault.
You're beautiful. You're beautiful. You are made for so much more than all of this. You're beautiful. You're beautiful. You are treasured, you are sacred, you are His. You're beautiful.
In the chorus, it goes on to say that you're treasured, you're sacred. You're His. You're beautiful. Listening to that over and over and over again and just bawling. It felt like the Lord was right there with me, saying these words to me over and over again, giving me the strength to go on. It was like Mercy Me created a song for me. And it gave me the strength to fight another day, to get out of bed and put another foot forward, because I am more than what happened to me. The abuse that I endured, those things don't define me. I've chosen to define it. I'm a child of God, and I can do anything with Christ in me. And this song reminds me of that every day. The song was released in November, September timeframe, and I didn't hear it. I picked up on it maybe in 11 or 12, and then it was a constant thing for me to listen to it over and over again. And that gave me the motivation that I needed to get help and to keep going. That's what this song means to me. The strength for me.
You were meant for so much more.
Tammy's story is one amongst many who have experienced military sexual trauma, or MST, during their time serving.
Force occurs, sexual encounters perpetrated while a person is unwilling or unable to give consent, inappropriate sexual jokes or lewd remarks, unwanted physical contact that makes one uncomfortable, and offers of something in exchange for sexual favors are all examples of MST experiences. Difficulty with relationships and social functioning, physical health problems such as difficulty of sleep, substance abuse problems, mental health conditions such as depression, are all symptoms that one can experience with MST.
One in four victims within the military do not report their experience because they fear retaliation. A third of victims are discharged even after reporting these incidents. In a study conducted in 2018, 76% of victims did not report the crimes committed against them.
In addition to 1 in 3 women experiencing MST, approximately 1 in 4 men do as well.
Personal stories remind us that we are not defined by our pain, but by our strength and resilience. By sharing with others to bring collective awareness, we can continue to walk this path of empowerment, support, and healing for all survivors.